You're listening to Paranormal TV Network, and you're tuned in to Haunted Moments, and I'm your host, Reverend Dr. Teresa F. Koch. Alton, Illinois, the most haunted town in America, it is said. The city of Alton, Illinois, is one of the most haunted places in the United States. Although it has been incorporated as a city with a population of less than 40,000 residents, Alton, Illinois, is usually described as a river town. Located in southwestern Illinois, just 15 miles from St. Louis, Alton sits on the banks of the mighty Mississippi River. Although it is a favorite haunt for ghost hunters, the city itself is rich in history. It was the site of the first Lincoln-Douglas debate in 1858. Prior to this, Alton gained notoriety in 1837 when printer Elijah Lovejoy, trying to stop a pro-slavery mob from running his printed press a third time, was murdered by a mob. A statue of Lovejoy still exists today in Alton. During the Civil War, Alton housed a Union prison. Confederate soldiers would often try to escape by crossing the river to Mississippi during the conflict. The city also found notoriety during Prohibition when bootleggers would seek refuge in the town. Several gang-related murders took place in Alton during this period. Many of the bodies were thrown into the river. Today, several ghost tour operators have cashed in on Alton's fame as being a haunted town. There are several haunted cities and sites in the city. The most famous is the McPike Mansion. This large Victorian-style mansion is said to be the home of its original proprietor, Paul, who died in 1945. Local folklore states that Paul loved the house so much he remained even after death. Ghosts have allegedly been captured on camera within this mansion. The McPike Mansion was the site of the first reports of paranormal activity back in the late 1940s. More were to follow. The Civil War not only plays an important role in Alton's history, but a role in the city's hauntings as well. Although all the remains of the Union Prison is one wall, the rest of the prison was demolished and is now home to the Madison County Urban League. This home is said to contain the ghost of a Confederate general who paces the basement, unhappy about the outcome of the war. The road that carried Confederate soldiers who died from smallpox while imprisoned to their graves is called Hop Hollow Road. This road is overgrown with trees, and those who have traveled the road report an eerie feeling. People in Alton report cries being heard from this road, even when there is no one around. The Enos Apartment Building in Alton was once a refuge for slaves escaping to the north. One of the last links of the Underground Railroad processed to freedom in later years, the building was used as a sanitarium for people with tuberculosis. This building is now said to not only be haunted by ghosts of those who died while trying to escape to freedom, but by many who died from tuberculosis, patients who lived their days in this building. Footsteps are heard, door open and close at will, and lights flicker on and off. The Enos Apartment Building is said to be one of the most haunted places in the town. Another popular haunt is the Mineral Springs Hotel. Locals tell the story of a man who was murdered during Prohibition in the hotel, whose spirit remains to this day. People talk about hearing a man's footsteps in the hallway and hearing the sounds of water leaking into their rooms without seeing any water there at all. Milton School is allegedly home to another ghost, the spirit of a murdered girl. The story regarding this haunt is that the child was killed by the school janitor, who later hung himself. Students who attended the school often spoke of strange encounters with a young girl who vanished after speaking to them. The school is now an office building, and the spirit of the child is said to regularly haunt many of the offices. Other haunts include the Cracker Factory, the Hartford Castle, and Lewis and Clark College, all with similar reports of paranormal activity. Alton, Illinois is definitely reported to be the most haunted town in America. You're tuned in to Paranormal TV Network, and you've been listening to Haunted Moments, and I am your host, Reverend Dr. Teresa F. Koch.